future. I honestly wanted to be everything. Everything from a race car driver to Iron Man, a fighter jet pilot, and I even wanted to be a rapper at one point. And as a child, there is no wrong answer for what your future can be like. It can literally be whatever you imagine it to be. But growing up, you start to realize a lot of things. Throughout your educational years, you're thrown lots of tips and facts on what an ideal future looks like. Well, actually, what people say an ideal future should look like. And you're geared in a direction where you have no choice but to listen to what people say. You graduate high school, you go to college, and you work half of your life until it's time for you to retire. But what's after retirement? What happens? Well, you die. You get old and you die. And as harsh as it sounds, people don't understand the importance of future. The importance of future in themselves, this country, the world, and even this universe. And what I believe is the biggest poison in us and the biggest poison in future is regret. It's poison, and people need to push hard, and they need to find the vehicle that moves them in their future. They need to find the motivation that drives them into achieving their future goals. And most importantly, you just need to stop listening to what people say, because whatever they say isn't true. And if anybody ever did it, if anybody ever created anything that is anything, then you can too. And what you were never told in school was that you just need to stop making excuses. You need to stop complaining, and nobody's listening. And they may pretend they're listening, but no one really cares. And what you need to do is make one person happy, and that's you. And then you can start to make other people happy. And you need to understand, are you doing the things that are putting you in the position for you to succeed in your future? Now, not only in the business world, but in life. Because when you're happy in life, well, then your business can roll. And remember, one life, it's all you get. Go talk to 70-year-olds, and they talk about regret. I wish is their opening line. Hey man, tell me about your life. Well, literally, I wish. They grew up in a generation that did not have the internet, and it was not practical for them to do the amazing things that we're doing, or the things that we could be doing that a lot of people don't. People want an amazing future. They want to live this amazing life, but they give up after 4 months after trying something new. Now, forget all the things your teachers and parents told you about what an ideal future should look like. I'm going to tell you what you were never told, or what was never really instilled in your mind, and that's purpose. And how can you find your life's purpose? And how can purpose shape your future? Remember, whatever you really want in life takes a tad bit longer than you really expect. If you think you can achieve something in 1 year, it'll probably take 2 years. And most people give up right before they're about to achieve what they want. They say that the temptation to give up is greatest right before you're about to succeed. And we live in a world where people are weak, where they want instant gratification. They say, oh, I'm gonna have a six pack, but they don't have a six pack 2 days later, so they give up. Well, they're gonna be stuck at the bottom, they're gonna stay there. You're gonna be wondering what your life's purpose is your whole life. Life is a little bit like a ladder, and whatever you want is at the top of the ladder. You start at the bottom. And everybody starts at the bottom. I don't care if you were born rich or if you were born poor. We all start at the bottom. And a lot of people try to jump that ladder. And what happens when you try to jump that ladder is that you slip and fall, and you're back to the bottom again. And it hurts. And a lot of people never get back up because the bottom, the pain is too much when they fall. So just go step by step. And if you want to be an astronaut, well, go to Cape Canaveral in Florida. You don't necessarily have to start as an astronaut, but start immediately on the path of curiosity to being an astronaut. You want to know how to start a business? Start a business. Well, people say, what business do I start? Well, any business. The goal is not that your first business is the best business. The goal is that you get started. You are one step up the ladder. To get what you want, you need to deserve what you want. And you probably do know what you want. And it's better to take action in what you want than to be stuck at the bottom forever. Make your future how you want it. Live your life's purpose. And don't live life in regret. Don't major in minor things. If you're majoring in something that's minor in your life, well, then you're doing it wrong. One life is all you get. What will you make out of it?
In 5 years, I envision myself graduated with my bachelor's degree in nursing. Working towards my next step would be becoming a nurse practitioner.